Now we are start our second video, multi-timer. So how to up to here, in first video everything is clear, I think. So first I will enter our numeric entries. So 100. It's a size I so I make 150 by 75. It's okay, and I will give address, internal memory. Suppose I will give here address 35. For example, and I will make duplicate. We are using here is three timers. Okay, one more I will make here. Duplicate. So 35, and we can see 36 and 37, these three address with me now. And I'll make little space. This is our pump. This pump tag. Okay, this is our internal memory tag. So now I will make duplicate here is 3. So it's 3, automatic address will be changed, you will see here 5.5, 5.6 and 5.7. okay, let's I will make also one another address, but not memory address. I will be make external link address. This is come from my PLC, so I will give the number 65. For example, 65. So I will make here also duplicate 3. And this one, that's look. So let's we know this one is standard. Picture, we will change little picture with us. So how to, okay, let's is off is blue, when in on is yellow. So this is changing because of our we know our internal memory, this tag and that tag from PLC memory. This is our set value. So timer 1, 2, 3. If we need to write, we can write here also. One. 4. So this one I'll make 2 number, text number 2 and text number 3. Our screen is complete. We need to write our macro. So again we'll go to clock macro. So here what we'll do first, my address, internal address, first timer was 35, so I will write 35 here. It's very simple. Okay, so after that this one is bit on is 5.5, and also one another bit, now bit on I'll copy here because it's this link. Bit number, what I give this one is 65, so it's already here I have 60, so better I will be give this one is 61, so I will give this one is a 61. This is memory bit also is on, and then I don't need to close here my stop my timer. I'll go to the next. Okay, our next will be again the same condition, if my timer. So simply I will be copy this one and enter space. I will be follow the same instruction. Now here mistake, this should be dollar sign because it's internal memory. Okay, this one internal memory 36, this is my timer number 2 is 36, timer number 2 is 36, and memory bit number 62, and internal bit tag, this one 5.5, number 2, now we are number 2, 5.6, so I will write here 5.6, and this one should be is, I will make 62. Again, on the same, I have the copy and paste here because of this mistake last time. $37, my bit, and this is my input, timer input 37. You can see here this. Okay, the internal bit tag is 5.7. Should be I change here 5.7, and then PLC bit, memory bit 67, here 62, should be I'll make here 63, because in sequence is not necessary, what you need you can be fix it. It's looks almost is good. So now our up to 37 is okay. Now after 37 is our last timer, we need to stop our counting. So $130 is equal to $37. What is the value of 37? It will be stop on 37. Again, else if this all conditions, then bit of, okay, same method. I'll make copy and paste here. 61 bit number, 62 and 63. So I'll give 61 of, 62 of, 63 of, and okay, is then again we'll go same method, copy this one, is here, so our first this value is 5.5, 5.6 and 5.7. The last value is 5.7. And then my 130 value, this if is off, it will become in 0. Okay, it's same. So update macro, clock macro. We will close. Okay, first compile, check what happened. There is any problem or not? I don't think so. So that's looks good. I will be go to page number 2. I give first value is 10, 20, 30. Okay, is off. So now remaining words, we have our PLC. First our PLC have what I give here, 60 61 62 63. Okay, so input number here also, LBM67, M60 M61 M M62 M63. So I give here I give output M65. Okay, I have another solution because of this. I am suffering with this volume 66 67 and 68. I'll make okay. We'll compile now. Download and it's on. So now I will go to make first I give this value to 20 40 and 50. Just I will on the timer. You can check 60 lamp number 2 and lamp number 3. Okay, I will switch off from here. Let's check, and I'll be make on from here from my PLC. And you can see, if you will not use this button, you can check this direct from the PLC input. But same method, no need to configure the button. So this is our timer, how to we are using. Thanks for watching the video.